Hi, it's Catherine Smith from Plan de Ville here in New York City. We're going inside today to meet with Julianna Bass, one of the newest designers on our site. Come on inside, let's meet her. So Julianna, tell me about the early days of your career. What was your first job?
Well, my first job was at a private label company right out of school. I was interning at Marc Jacobs and I needed to find a full-time job, but also a job that would allow me to like maintain my position there as a lowly intern, excited. So yeah, it was a private label company, not glamorous at all, but an eye-opening experience tossed into the industry.
Do you have any mentors?
I do, my investor, my lawyer. I know it sounds boring, but like on the business end of things, they've been great mentors along the way. And I'd say my college costume design professor was one of my mentors and my very first art teacher. Cultivated my artistic path. So, yeah.
What are your top tips for women starting out in their careers today?
Well, especially if you're starting out in a creative field, you don't want to forego any of your serious CEO responsibilities. Not that I did that or anything, but when you're creative, it's easy to get caught up in, you know, what you love the most and nurture that side and kind of push the other to the back burner, and definitely just remember it is a business at the end of the day, so you have to devote time to the things that you might not be as most interested in.
Like accounting and bookkeeping.
Yeah, and days off, taxes, yeah. And payroll.
So tell me about building your brand. What's maybe your favorite memory or a really big victory that you've had?
My favorite memories would probably be of in my atelier in Berlin. Before momentum was really going, before things started to build, it was free time. Me and my pattern maker and a few people here and there, like artists that I work with, would come in, and we just had a great creative time. And those are some really great memories to date.
How about your biggest victory?
Well, I mean, as boring as it might sound, I mean, as a fashion designer, it's really hard to secure funding. So, you know, having people believe in your vision and your talents and enough to, you know, invest in it is a pretty big victory in my book. So
back to balance. How do you balance your work and family, personal life?
Well, I've not always been good at it, but I kind of have to force myself more. Like, not really. I mean, I want the balance, but I just have to say, okay, you know, you must do X, Y, and Z this week to take care of yourself. Every week, I'm like, okay, when am I going to work out? When am I going to see this person? When am I going to spend time with this person? Like, how am I going to navigate my life this week outside of work? So it's just more or less making it a priority to do the things that you want to do, other than, you know, just 24/7 constantly being immersed in work.
What's your work uniform?
Unflattering high-waisted jeans and a black turtleneck.
Same. Yeah. So, who is your dream woman to dress and why?
Oh, there are plenty of them. Naomi Campbell, Yasmin Sewell, Michelle Obama, Tracee Ellis Ross, any strong females, unabashedly herself, with a distinct look and style.
What do you do for fun?
Basic things. Hang out with my friends, hang out with my boyfriend, brunch, drinks, you know. Sorry, yes, basic answer, but you know, I feel like I have an eclectic work week and then, you know, stressful, so I need to just unwind and chill.
What's next for you?
I mean, I feel like it's like a colorful hamster wheel at times. It's like one season is done, you're on to next. So we're working on Autumn Winter 18 at the moment. And our fashion tech project is still going. So just on to the next.